Happy morning. Today's topic is about sudden infant death syndrome, and in this video lecture we will be discussing regarding the definitions, followed by the history narrated by the parent. Third, there are many theories of caution, and we will be discussing each theories of caution in detail, and followed by the epidemiological features such as highly suggestive of SIDS when discussed, and in later section of the video wherein we will be discussing regarding the autopsy features and followed by the medical legal importance of SIDS. And first and foremost, the synonyms for SIDS are cord death, cribe death, and sudden unexplained infant death are the other terminologies used as an alternative to SIDS. And regarding the definition, the definition for SIDS is: it is an unexpected death of an infant without any medical history, and the cause of death remains inexplicable even after a thorough autopsy and a meticulous death scene investigation. And from the other standard books, wherein sets of the definition is almost similar to a negative autopsy. And here in this definition, it is defined as a sudden death of a seemingly healthy infant whose death remains unexplained even after a thorough case investigation, death scene examination, third, the review of clinical history, fourth, after a complete autopsy, and even after serological, toxicological, histopathological and microbiological examinations. And regarding the issues related to SIDS, SIDS is a third leading cause for infant mortality, and most of the deaths have been occurring during a course of sleep, and discovered at death by the parent on the next day morning. And major problems that exist are due to the deficiency of the pathognomic characteristic features of autopsy, and wherein a salient feature that has been lacking in, wherein most of the cases where cause of death remains undetermined and ultimately leads to a negative autopsy. And regarding the history that have been narrated by the parent, wherein typically the child has been quite well, no issues at all, no any past illnesses or past medical history or any other congenital issues. And wherein the history is, when a child has been put on to the bed, and the next day morning they discovered the child has been dead, and wherein there is no any classical signs and symptoms as far as by the parent. And in some cases there have been minor issues in form of a minor URI, and wherein features of a common cold and a sneezing were the issues. And in some other cases wherein a parent complains of an issue of a minor GI disturbances on the prior night, and followed by the child was being discovered dead on the bed. And whatever may be the history as narrated, wherein there is no any exact sign and symptom or a salient history as we seen in other cases, those are lacking in case of a SIDS. Regarding theories of caution, wherein there are multiple theories that have been advocated regarding SIDS, but not even a one or not even a single theory is found to be highly suggestive why this is occurring, and there have been number of causes, and to make it as simple, we have taken only the causes that have been highly debated and highly not accepted. We can't take those have been accepted, but most commonly suggested theories have been discussed in upcoming slides. And there are other theories wherein they say that it is in a combination of the one and another, and where ultimately they leads to on a common pathway of on a cardiac respiratory failure, and other theories relating to metabolic disorders have been even advocated, and wherein a child passes through on a vulnerable period of development, those could be the causes. And we listed some of the theories of caution, and followed by we will be discussing those in upcoming slides. Most commonly advocated theories are towards allergy, and here in case the first and foremost is cow's milk protein allergy. And when and where a newborn being exposed to cow milk protein, not all newborn develops this allergy, but a vulnerable or a selective based on their the characteristics of their parent, they may show features of allergy wherein when they have been exposed to a cow milk protein, they may develop features of vomiting, signs of indigestion, and even after a first feed, they may tend to vomit the same, and swelling of lips, swelling of eyelids, wheezing, and features of diarrhea, and blood in poop, and refusal to feed, and in extremities, they may even develop eczema, and these are the features towards cow milk protein allergy. And the second allergy that have been advocated is towards house mite allergy. And when they have been exposed, they tell the newborn, the vulnerable age group, 2 to 4 months after birth, may develop features of red patches over the extremities, and in extreme cases, wherein over to the faces also. And here again, this theory may not again whatever we are about to discuss in upcoming slides, none of the theory is being approved, and still a debatable issues towards the theories of caution regarding critical diaphragmatic failure, and where due to presence of an infection or otherwise due to the risk factors, like first and foremost is the undevelopment or undeveloped respiratory muscles, second a non-lethal infections, third the prone resting position of a newborn, fourth an REM sleep could be the risk factors wherein contributing to critical diaphragmatic failure, and in some cases there been minor infections which is in acute in onset, and where they ultimately reduce the ultimately causes reduction in the diaphragmatic force generation, and the capacity of the diaphragm has been reduced, the functional ability of a diaphragm that has been reduced, and ultimately it contribute to the critical diaphragmatic failure, wherein there have been respiratory compromises occurs due to, and ultimately death results in. And regarding the deficiencies, third advocated theory towards the deficiency of essential antibodies, biotin, and essential minerals in form of calcium, magnesium, and selenium deficient state can also have been advocated, that can also lead to SIDS, and GABA deficiency of gamma globin, and deficiency of essential vitamins B, C, D, and ER. When there have been a deficiency state, and they say that it can also lead to features of SIDS. regarding genetic issues, wherein it can involve two major systems. First and foremost system has been brain stem or the central nervous system, wherein any abnormality that arises in a brain stem, and brain stem being a primary area for a respiratory center, and any abnormality due to an serotonergic system where give rise to defective impulses that have been carried into the respiratory as well as the autonomic responses, where there been a compromise where ultimately it can leads to a death of a newborn. Regarding the second system is cardiovascular system, wherein a genetic mutated or there been a defect in gene coding of a faulty ion channel or an ion channel based associated protein, any defect can be the issues. And the most common examples are long QT syndrome, short QT syndrome, Brugda syndrome, and polymorphic ventricular tachycardia. Other genetic issues that could arise as an causative, as a theory of caution, are faulty interleukin 1 receptor antagonist defects, MAO molecular polymorphisms. Thirdly, left ventricular hypertrabeculations could be the causes. And regarding left ventricular hypertrabeculations, wherein high trabeculated myocardium and followed by spongy myocardium are the causative etiopathogenesis. And due to presence of these defects, wherein the signs symptoms could arise as heart failure, or it can characteristic as with the features of arrhythmias, or even it can manifest as an features of thromboembolic events. And the exact issues in left ventricular hypertrabeculations are there have been in a wide variety of mutations are the responsible for this picture. Deficiency of hormones like parathyroid be the one such reason. And secondly, any respiratory infection, especially with Staphylococcus aureus and other viral infections, could be the reason. And regarding inflammatory reactions, in a small group of SIDS cases where there have been a demonstration of high levels of cytokines, especially interleukin 1 beta, interleukin 6, and tumor necrosis factor alpha concentrations have been found in higher level, and maybe also a possible explanation for SIDS. And regarding other causes, wherein if there been an obstruction of airway, either due to anatomical abnormalities or a feature of a nasal edema, or other causes like nasal obstruction or an inflammation or on a both, and in cases where there been excessive mucus secretions in the respiratory passages could be the reason. And other causes for obstruction of airways could be flaccid pharynx in a hypotonic baby, faulty neck posture, and laryngeal spasms could be the other causes, wherein another advocated hypothesis regarding theories of caution are possible. And regarding the sleep position, and a child who has been made to sleep in prone position has a 3 times high risk to develop SIDS and or compared to other sleep position. And the reason being why in prone position, first and foremost, the asphyxia could occur in due to airway compression, and secondly, rebreathing of an exhaled gases in a face down position is more likely, and thirdly, when a newborn has been placed in a prone position and wherein an impaired heat loss with a subsequent hypothermia when a face being pressed against the bedding could be the reason. And other are again relating to feet stress, wherein impaired cardiorespiratory regulations are more likely to occur. And comparing to other sleep position, and especially in prone position, where there are more chances for more bacterial growth and heavier growth of staph aureus and E. coli in nasal samples from the infants who sleep on their abdomens compared to the other babies sleep on their backs. And again relating to sleep, wherein most of the cases wherein 50% of SIDS is being associated wherein the newborn being sharing a bed with another person here, and here could be the maternal or the paternal. And second causes relating to sleep is sleep apnea, wherein prolonged sleep apnea in a certain infants, hypoxia death can more likely to occur. And sleep induced arrhythmias are also more likely to occur. Harmful materials, and here the issue is related to the mattress, where most of the mattress contain phosphorus, arsenic and antimony components as in a fire retardant. And here the sleeping infant, as a result of the warmth and the perception, wherein infections by the microorganisms are more likely, and due to a chronic exposure wherein generating phosphines, arsine and stilbenes from these material can lead to poisoning, and ultimately it can lead to death of a newborn. And regarding the miscellaneous the theories, wherein adrenal insufficiency, conduction system anomalies, deficient liver enzymes, gastroesophageal reflexes, hypothermia, hyperthermia, and impaired glial neuro interactions in cardiorespiratory centers, and metabolic disorders, neurogenic shock, sodium overload in feet, suffocation by bed clothing and pillow are other miscellaneous causes wherein death can occur and it can leads to SIDS. Morphological features, and first and foremost the incidence, and here in case 0.6 per thousand live births may be the victims of SIDS. And second, the age group wherein predominant incidence is being seen when the age of the newborn is between 2 to 4 months, and highly vulnerable group and in due course of development are more likely to develop SIDS. And when you compare the sex of the newborn, male are highly predominant comparatively to the female newborns. And geographical distribution, and again it is worldwide, and there is no any exact in an epicenter for SIDS. And wherein the environmental factors, wherein when the newborn been exposed to in a cigarette smoke or by in a drug abuse during in course of in a pregnant state or after being born are more likely to be the victims of SIDS. Child related factors, first and foremost the term basis preterm infants, and here preterm infants are more likely to develop SIDS. And the other factor which plays in a vital is the birth weight, and if on a low birth weight in a newborn, more likely to develop SIDS. And second, the question arises with immunization with non-immunized newborns. If a newborn is being immunized less frequently, more likely to develop SIDS, and early and more frequent immunization may reduce the risk of SIDS. Thirdly, towards multiple birth babies, and incidence being higher in 3 times when there have been members of a twin pair, and still more higher in triplets. And the reason could be because of multiple birth babies are generally premature and they are on a low birth weight. And here there is factors more likely towards the female counterpart, and here when age of the mother has been less, the young mothers, the child born to them carry high risk of SIDS. Secondly, if there been a history of alcohol in a mother, and again the incidence rate have been reported higher, and when you compare to the non-alcohol consuming mothers. And the reason could be due to under influence, where the incidence significantly increases, and due to consumption of alcohol, it is hypothesized that alcohol impairs the maternal capacity to carry out their work. Other factors, miscellaneous factors, first and foremost will be the socioeconomic factor, more likely in poor families. Second, regarding the time of death, death usually occurs during the sleep and at all times of a night, and in wherein some documents wherein moderate highly cases have been reported in early morning hours also. Regarding the season, more likely to occur in months of winter. And regarding the latitude, more prevalent in the countries wherein within a higher latitudes. Factors, and these risk factors carry more weightage and more likely to develop this at a later point of time. And if there been a past history, either on a brother or on a sister who had an SIDS, and her or his death is yet to be identified, exact cause is yet to be identified, and if there been a past occurrence, and more likely to occur in other consecutive babies to born so. And secondly, when a head has been covered with a bed cloth, more likely. Thirdly, towards either a late or no prenatal care by the primary caregivers, wherein high chances of developing SIDS can. And other towards prematurity, and again ultimately leads to low birth weight. And other causes will be the short time between pregnancies are also carries a high risk, and soft bedding in crib again more likely chance to develop it. And at autopsy, there is no any pathognomonic finding, and here whatever the finding will be almost minimal. Either it can lead to an obscure autopsy, and or otherwise towards a negative autopsy, where even after a meticulous search, nothing has been discovered, and those autopsies will be termed, and those newborns will be termed as an SIDS. And here, in some cases wherein if an exact pathology has been found, then those deceased newborn will not be termed as an SIDS. And first, external features: the face appears PLR, no petechial hemorrhages over the face, eyes, and regarding the hand, wherein it been appears clenched, and it may contain the fibers of bed clothes. Definitive pathology, wherein earlier the case have been marked as an SIDS, and 15% of cases that have been converted, wherein after a meticulous search during the course of autopsy, where a definitive pathology like congenital heart disease, Down syndrome, pneumonia, tracheobronchitis have been identified. And once the pathology has been identified or been discovered, and it knows no more, it remains as a case of an SIDS, then autopsy report should not mention it as a case of a SIDS. As per the definition, remember, wherein the findings are minimal, or it is not sufficient enough to prove so, or there is no finding at all, then those cases can be termed as SIDS. And if you are able to find out a pathology, then make sure that you enter that pathology as a causative factor for the cause of death. And wherein child nostrils, mouth bleeding at the scene of crime may be stained with milk or on a blood-stained colored froth may be seen. And in respiratory passages, wherein froth, milky vomit, shedding of individual tracheobronchial epithelial cells may be seen. And signs of inflammatory lesions on the part of larynx, bronchitis, bronchiolitis, or pneumonitis, pleuritis may be seen, and or otherwise either is seen as an individual or in various combinations. And regarding lung signs, where surface may appear patchy, uniform purplish discoloration, consistency may be firm, and weight appears to be decreased, and pathology features like congestion and edema may be seen. Regarding the petechial hemorrhages, most commonly seen on the visceral surfaces of heart, lungs, and thymus, and the most common finding seen about in 75% of cases of SIDS, and it could be, the reason could be the terminal inspiratory efforts against closed glottis can lead to this picture. Regarding histopathological finding, wherein bronchi may show peribronchular, bronchiolar, cellular infiltration, and a brain wherein bilateral hypoplasia of an occult nucleus can be seen. And in case of heart, conduction system may be resorptive degeneration can also be seen. And regarding lungs, patchy alveolar collapse can be seen. Alveolar walls may be appear thickened, and aggression of platelets, neutrophils, and other inflammatory markers can be also seen. And regarding biochemical estimations, wherein increased levels of cytokines, especially interleukin 1 beta, interleukin 6, tumor necrosis factor alpha in blood and CSFs have been demonstrated. And regarding the genetic testing, and primarily it done to exclude any genetic disorders. The importance of SIDS, wherein a case of an infanticide may be misdiagnosed as an SIDS due to lack of evidences, even at scene of crime, as classed in during the course of autopsy. And Meadows dictums states that one, sudden infant death is often a tragedy, and two is of suspicious, and three is of murder until proven otherwise. And secondly, SIDS infants as an organ donors. And there have been a lot of confusion existing previously regarding the validity of using the organs, and because of unclear etiology. And now the studies have proven so the heart and other organs from the SIDS infant can be transplanted to the other infants, to the needy infant, and there is no any increased incidence of death in the recipient. Thirdly, towards civil and criminal cases involving SIDS, where generally they are failed in court because the court recognized that these as a natural phenomenon. And fourth, this is a natural death in which parents may be wrongfully linked for a criminal involvement or an act of a negligence. Thank you so much for your patient listening. If there been any doubt, query relating to the content of the video, kindly address those issues in comment section below or otherwise through any of the social media links provided in description.